Hello and welcome to this How Do I video. Today I will show you how you can create Power Apps with data from Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2017. At the end of this video, you can create a follow-up app with customers and their item sales from Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2017. My objective of this video is to give our salespeople an app where they can see all the customers with their total sales and also give the possibility to dive into the details. I will guide you through the following steps. First, I will set up NAV and I will sign up and configure Microsoft Power Apps. Then, I will create an app in Power Apps where we can follow up our customers and their sales. And finally, I will test it and show you the result of our app. Now let's jump to the first step. First, I will set up NAV. To make NAV ready for Microsoft Power Apps, we need to publish an OData web service. In this page, I will add the customer list page and enable it, and the query of the item sales by customer and also enable it. This is all we need to do in NAV. Now I will sign up for Microsoft Power Apps by opening the following URL. On this site, you can choose between different plans. As you can see, if you have Dynamics 365, this is included. For business users, you have a small fee per month per user, and then you have a subscription for app makers and admins. And in the future, there will also be a specific plan for developers. Once signed in, the first thing we need to do is creating a connection to NAV. And this can be done by selecting Dynamics NAV to make connection to Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2017. Next, we need to provide the general OData URL like this and fill up the necessary username and password. And finally, I also need to fill up the company name to which it will connect to and create it. Okay, now that we have configured NAV in Microsoft Power Apps, we can move on and start creating an app. Let's start creating a new app for our salespeople so they can follow up their customer easily. You can choose to make an app with the Studio for Windows, or you can do it right within your browser. For this demo, I will choose the browser. As you can see, you can create an app from data or from a template or an empty app. To make things easy, I will start from data, and because Dynamics NAV isn't listed, I will press the arrow to get our own connections. And as you might expect it, Dynamics NAV is listed here. Next, we will choose the right data set, and as you can see, all the published OData web services are listed here. To start, we will use the customer list and press connect. Now, Power Apps will build a sample app with the selected data set in a minute. The created app contains a list with a view and an edit card of the customer right out of the box. Next, I will tweak the look and feel of this app in this WYSIWYG designer. First, I will change the layout by picking this template, and as you can see, the design changes immediately. The content of the label can also be changed by simply selecting the body, and on the left you will find all present labels with their current value. The possible field values are all the fields that are published in the OData web service, as you can see. I will change the first with the name of the customer, the second to the postcode, and the last will contain the total sales in the local currency. To use the search and sorting functionality, we need to update this function on the browse gallery. We want to search on the name and the postcode, and the sorting must be on the total sales. So the function will look like this. Next, I will create a new screen where I want to show all the item sales of that customer. We'll create a new screen, and then I will connect it to the item sales by customers as follows. First, I will give it a layout, and then I will add the data source item sales by customer on this page. And now I need to attach the new data source to the browse gallery by update the search and sort function on this page. The special thing here is that I only want the records of the customer that I have selected in the previous screen, and this can be done by use filter the item sales by customer dataset where the selected number of the browser category 1 is in the customer number. I will also change the search sorting statement so that my final function will look like this. Next, I will change the content of the labels, where the first label will contain the description of the item, the second one will have the item number, and the last one will have the actual sales. I also will change the title to make it more clear. Before we can use this screen, we need to add a button or an icon on the view screen. I will choose an icon and link it to my new screen by changing the action to the screen 1 on the select action. I also want the behavior when I select the button. Now our app is ready to be tested. But before we can do it, we will give it a name and choose an icon, color and a picture, and then save it. You can also grant user of your own organization by simply sending an invitation on this page. So only granted users can use this app. Let's move on, where I will show and test this app. To test this app, you need to install the Microsoft PowerApps app on your phone. You can find it in the App Store, and once installed, the first thing you need to do is sign in. After you are signed in, you can see all the available PowerApps where you have permissions of. So let's open our previous created app. When you open the app, it will connect to NAV in the background and present all the data. So you can change the sorting like this. And now I want to search for the customer Aiden. The app refreshes its data and gives us the customer. And now we go to the overview and sees that this customer has bought these three items. So easy. And all this is done by simply clicking. And I think the possibilities are endless. We are come to the part where I will summarize my steps. First, I have explained which settings and configuration must be done in NAV and Microsoft PowerApps to get things done. Then I have created an app that our salespeople can use to follow up their customers. And finally, I showed how the app works on my phone. Here are some resources where you can find additional information. On the DLP, you can find more information, including how do I videos like this one. And the last one is a Microsoft PowerApps guided learning site, where you can learn to create PowerApps step by step. Thank you for watching this How Do I video, where I'll create PowerApps with data from Microsoft Dynamics NAV 2017. This video was created in collaboration with Microsoft and the Training Center Platan. See you next time in another How Do I video.